I know we want to talk about sustainability, but actually, because we're just getting some breaking news on the tariffs, do you worry that European companies will be affected by what the Trump administration has just announced?
Of course we worry so long when we not get the clarity, but we have good opportunities now to solve the issue or actually stabilize or calm down the problem, because Cecilia Malmström, EU Trade Commission, just visited Washington, D.C., and according her, there is a prospect for starting some sort of negotiation process with the United States, with the authorities there, to address the metal tariff issue. So the facts are on our side, but we are not always sure whether the facts matters or not.
I mean, what can the European do, right? I mean, you can go to the WTO. What else can you do?
First of all, we try to avoid trade war. But if nothing else helps, then we do our countermeasures. We set higher standards to certain American products. And then, of course, we will take U.S. into the WTO. But now our priority is to avoid all this to happen. And that's why Cecilia Malmström, Trade Commissioner, had a good, very fruitful visit to Washington, where they discussed with Trade Secretary Ross on the opportunities to calm down the situation and start negotiations. So, right now, it looks a bit brighter than a week ago.
Okay, I know we want to talk about sustainability. I guess the concern is that governments are distracted by tariffs instead of focusing on sustainable growth and sustainable financing. How are governments prioritizing?
Well, in this trade policy, EU is always united. We may have different views, but once we take our positions, we are always united. Sustainable finance is a big opportunity for the whole financial industry around the globe. But Europe wants to be front runner. We want to create enabling regulatory environment for financial sector in order to shift the financing decisions from the current to more circular, to more sustainable. And that's why we came up with our proposals just a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah, which we'll talk to about in a second. Do you think that most EU companies will be exempt from the tariffs? And again, if the Chinese retaliate against the U.S., can you attract investment in Europe? Does it actually, could you see a benefit from a possible trade war between China and the U.S.?
It's absolutely clear that EU must get exemption as a trading bloc, because we have internal market. We cannot accept that some countries or some companies in some countries are treated better than the others, because it would destroy our internal market. So that's why EU must be treated as a trading bloc. Of course, there is risk of retaliation spiral, which is always very bad for everybody. So in trade wars, there are not winners, there are only losers. And the loser is normal citizens who will lose a job. What happens if something happens too early to speculate anything? Everybody knows our position. We want to avoid trade war. We don't want to harm any of our trading partners. Instead, we are the most open trading and investment market what you can find in the world.
I mean, how much of the time here at the Commission is spent to talk about tariffs or the relationship with the administration, sustainable finance or Brexit? Is it a third, a third, a sixth?
Well, metal tariffs are kind of a storm in the water glass. It's a problematic issue right now. We don't want it to happen, and that's why we allocate lots of human resources to solve the problem. But the bigger issue, obviously, is the further development of business environment in Europe, and that's why sustainable finance, it's a mega issue compared to the two others. So Brexit, of course, it's very unfortunate, but in terms of how much time it takes in everyday Commission life, not that much, because we have negotiation team which is negotiating on behalf of whole EU, but rest of the Commission concentrates on future-oriented things like circular economy, sustainable finance, artificial intelligence, defense, security, and this kind of stuff, which will integrate Europe. And Europe will be a better market also for external investors.
When you look at sustainable finance and the action plan that the Commission put forward, what do investors ask of you? Do they need something more concrete? Do they need more investments from government? And is that the only way to get the private partnership, private public, to have real teeth?
Well, if looking at who are the sustainable investors today, they are normal market participants, private sector. And they message to us was very clear. We need transparency. We need a category or classification what is really sustainable, because they don't want to invest in projects which are greenwashed, for instance. So they asked EU to create taxonomy, what is really sustainable, what is real green investment, and this is what we are doing at the moment. We had high-level expert group preparing our proposal, and we adopted many of the ideas. Mm-hmm. So it was an industry stakeholder-driven process, and I'm pretty sure that the feedback is very, very positive.
But again, if you're a government, so if you're France or Germany, then you need to create infrastructure. Sustainable finance means that you need to put a lot of money up front. How difficult is it to get that done when you're trying to fight fire with Brexit, for example, because you lose maybe some exports that your country is bringing to the UK?
Well, fundamentally, sustainable finance is just exactly the same as whatever financing. So basically, you decide where to invest, you are calculating returns, etc. But now the difference is that sustainable is sustainable in the long term. Unsustainable is, for instance, investments to coal sector. Mm-hmm. So that's why from business perspective, there's no difference if the fundamentals are right. And now we want to create enabling regulatory framework which would enable or increase security amongst the investors' community, that if they want to invest in sustainable projects, they can be very sure that it is sustainable and not just greenwashed.
Okay, well, how can you make sure that actually the money goes in and people take it seriously?
Consumers are in the center point, because you have seen the same thing happening in all parts of business. Consumers have started to ask more sustainable products, more mm-hmm. sustainable services. And now we want to include financial services to this same picture. So consumers are in center, but also financial sector itself seems to understand very clearly that if we don't do anything, the climate change will cause a lot of harm, and it will change the business, not only financial business, but all the other businesses, and it will lead to bad situation. So there is a genuine will within the financial services that something must be done, and now the question is how to do it.
Speaking about financial services and speaking on Brexit, what do you make of this equivalency? How much flexibility will the Commission show towards the UK?
Well, this is a question of our future relationship. When we negotiate with third country on trade agreements, we have to calculate pluses and minuses. In our current trade agreements, financial services don't play a major role. But of course, UK might be slightly different, but it's too early to assess what role financial services plays in our trade agreement. By the way, the future trade agreement between the EU and UK is the first ever done by anybody, where we negotiate on worsening the situation from the current situation, because normally trade agreements tends to create better regulatory environment for business, but this time around it's different, unfortunately.
But Vice President, the problem is that in the UK they say if we don't talk about it now, then it delays it, which means that actually banks move people out and you lose that business.
Well,
right?
we are negotiating all the time. So withdrawal agreement is number one, then transition agreement is number two, and once those two have been adopted, then we can start negotiating on future trade agreement. So lots of work has already been done, but we are not there yet.